Okay, good afternoon and welcome to the latest Atta webinar. This afternoon, Ultimate Safari's Birgit Becker is going to take us on a journey as Ultimate Safari's Namibia migrates into Under Canvas. There will be the opportunity for questions at the end of the presentation, and if you have any questions, please type these into the chat box and we will address them at the end of the session. I trust that everyone can hear us clearly. It has, however, just started raining in Windhoek, so I'm hoping that Birgit's connection is going to remain stable. So I will now hand over to you, Birgit, to take us on through the presentation. Birgit, can you hear us? Birgit, can you hear me?
Talk about ultimate and our end the canvas. I try to curb my enthusiasm, which is always very difficult when I talk about Namibia. So thank you to everybody who's listening in today, and let's get the show going. So a little introduction on Ultimate Safaris for those that don't know us. We're based in Windhoek, Namibia's capital city. We've proudly focused on Namibia only. We are an inbound tour operator in DMC, so our focus is Namibia and the tours we do within Namibia. We work exclusively with the trade only, so we don't promote direct. We let, you know, our trade deal with all those hardships. We're very proud of our state-of-the-art vehicles, very proud. Did you know that we travel over 2,500 miles to Moshi and back just to have the vehicles customized specific requirements? And a little bit more about the cost just now. We now employ over 18 guides, all of them English speaking. We don't use freelance guides, nor do we do multiple language tours. It's always only in English. This is our focus, and our guides are probably one of our people are probably our greatest pride that we put together. We've also created an agent login site. I go into it a little bit afterwards. But you're very welcome to go on our website in the top right, sign up. You get information like Wi-Fi access at the camps, download high-res images, find information on frequently asked questions like where do you see shipwrecks, Google Maps, everything's on there. Then, of course, our journeys on the canvas, which we launched in 2016 and the focus of this webinar. And then we're also talking a little bit about our Conservation Travel Foundation, our contribution giving back to Namibia's conservation efforts. Now, this is a site of beauty, our land cruises. I mentioned them before. Considering that, on average, your guests will probably travel about 1,300 miles on a round trip in Namibia, we really want to ensure that our guests explore in the most reliable, comfortable vehicle suitable for our conditions. Guaranteed window seat, air conditioning, pop-top roofs, and four. You can't imagine a better vehicle for Namibian conditions. But even though we love our land cruises, we think it's the best way to explore Namibia. Do a range of flying safaris that includes twin-engine aircrafts, executive PC-12s, helicopter air transfers, depending which airstrips they can land, of course. Some of our specialities is, I mean, there's lots to do in Namibia, and we tend to ask our partners' interests of the client so we can really fine-tune the itinerary planning. But we're doing a lot of tailor-made active tours, including hiking trails, and I go into the hiking trails, which is a part of our journey under Canvas. We do mountain bike tours, kayaking, fat biking excursions. We are very family-friendly. We've seen a huge increase in family travel to Namibia, especially generational travel. Grandma pays for the entire family, grandkids, grandkids. We've hosted up to 19 family members. Then sincere cultural engagements. For those that don't know me, this is me with the purple hair. We actually visited this Himba village, and for once I was the tourist attraction. These charming Himba ladies have never seen someone with purple hair before. They didn't even have color for purple, so they were very fascinated. We had so much fun trying to explain the hairdos of the Himba and my hair. It was a very special experience, which is enabled because our guides visit specific villages where we have a relationship with, we speak the local dialect. So it's a very special experience. And we do birding tours. We have an agreement with Swarovski binoculars. We need great binoculars to find the birds. Ooh, there's some thunder. I don't know if anybody heard that now. Very exciting. Some of other specialties are executive travel. We have hosted quite a few gazillionaires successfully. We do a surprisingly number of self-drive safaris in Namibia, generally only 4x4s. We don't do the small cars. And photographic safaris, we offer beanbags, trailers. We know photographers carry a lot of extra gear. Their needs are a little bit different to your average tourist. I want to get up at 3 a.m. to get to the spot before that. So specialty of photography tours is very, very much what we do. Then I've joined our Travel Conservation Travel Foundation. Last year, we donated over $1.3 million in rand through partners and guests that have traveled with us, as well as an initiative. We work very closely with the Rhino Trust, the Giraffe Conservation Fund, Africat, and Dr. Flip Stunder of the Desert Lion Foundation. We really believe in giving back to the country that has been so good to us Namibians over the years. And now, the best part of the presentation, our journeys on the canvas. So we've always at Ultimate have run mobile camps, a bit of rustic pitched dome tents in remote areas. Usually we did it to cater for film groups. Often it was the focus to explore wild areas, have certain flexibility. We ran it occasionally, it wasn't a big part of our business. But we've seen that there was such demand for mobile camps. People really want to go back to basics and getting back to the experiences of being out in nature. So we've decided to reinvest into our mobile camps. We rebranded it Journeys on the Canvas. We've invested in these Mero tents, which were slightly customized for our needs. Stretcher beds, actually long extended stretcher beds for our American clientele. It's important to note that these Journeys on the Canvas aren't your traditional pitch up and go to a new place each day. If you look at the bottom left of the slide, this is our Land Cruiser, which we lovingly call the Beast. Fully kitted with fridge, freezer, oven, stove, geyser for heating up our clients' equipment. And fully loaded, this vehicle is heavy and takes forever to get to the next destination. And the whole point of our camps is that the camp is ready and set up by the time guests arrive. It's not participatory. So we'd rather select area that is wild and exclusive, and from there use it as a base from which to explore Namibia instead of pitching up and going somewhere else every second day. And that has gone really well for us in terms of the explorations. We don't pitch in public camps. We don't go where everybody else with a roof tent goes. The point is to remote and wild areas. The point is to go away from the normal tourist routes, get out of the car more, get away from this routine of prescribed lodge daily activity schedules, you know, sleep under the stars sometimes, have special lunches, really relish slow travel and explore. Now, we were really successful with these journeys on the canvas, and so we were looking for spots where we can actually pitch our camps. And we were actually approached by the Huap concession if we would consider pitching our campsites, our camps on their concession. A few years ago, seven black rhinos were reintroduced on the Huap on the canvas. The problem is that this area is quite difficult to access and logistically very difficult to manage a lodge there. So for all these Huap were custodians to these black rhino, but there was very little benefit or reward or revenue for them beyond the Rhino ranges. So we arrived, we completely fell in love with this area, and 2 years ago, end of 2016, we built what we call the Hoop Under Canvas Camp. It's a semi-permanent camp, it's still very seasonal, opening April to May, to November. And what is unique about this place specifically, it is as a base we explore from there, and it's always only exclusively sold for our guests. So you will never have this camp sharing with other guests. If we have honeymooners, this camp is there for them. If a family of five, this camp is for them. If we have a special group arranged for one of our trade partner, this camp is for them. The focus has always been on this is exclusively for you. It's still a tented camp. It still has this mobile camp feel. You see we have bucket showers. We do have flush toilets in this camp, but it's still stretching beds, very communal, open, this experience. In the bottom right, you actually see family unit, which is dome tent pitched next to the main family unit. And the whole point is the rhinos. We work with Save the Rhino Trust, and we actually join the rhino rangers on rhino trekking. It's so much fun for guests, even if you don't find the rhino. Just the engagement and learning about the rhino conservation in Namibia is a highlight for all the guests. And because the camp is booked exclusively, the rhino trekking is done exclusively. With the success of Robin and Canvas, we were actually approached by a variety of concessionaires and private landowners if we would consider pitching a tent on their site. And so we were approached by the land over Neuhof Game Reserve, Nature Reserve, a piece of paradise in the Namib Desert, completely private, has never had any tourists on it. It's been a reclaimed nature reserve. It's only a 30-minute drive from the Sesrim Gate, which is the entrance to Sossus Vlei. So you have the advantages of good access to one of Namibia's best tourist attractions, but on a private reserve, pristine, wildlife is extremely prolific for what is essentially a desert landscape. We've got mountain zebras there, kudu, springbok, and night sky gazing, best night skies you can imagine. Photography is amazing. The camp is going to open in April, 1st of April. We have our first guest on the 2nd of April. It looks more permanent than it actually is. The only thing that's really permanent is the gabion walls, which is wind protection against the Namib desert winds. But otherwise, this tent is for seasonal, being pitched in April, taken off in November. We've done recycled oil drums as the roofing. But the point is really low sustainability, mobile, semi-mobile camping. Then, now that we've got all these pristine areas from which we can operate exclusively, we launched last year our Stella Escapes. Sleeping under the open stars. It usually starts with an afternoon stroll in the second afternoon, about an hour. You arrive in time for sundowners at the Fletcher camp set out, fireside camping dinner. So you literally have this night sky overwhelmed by the Milky Way sleep out for the night. We do it for up to six guests, again, exclusively set up. Next morning, wake up to hot coffee and rusks. Then you walk back to the main camp, the Hoop Under Canvas or Sossus Under Canvas, where hot breakfast awaits you. This one is really exciting because Namibia is known for their clear skies and doesn't rain a lot. And it's just, you want to get outside as much as possible. People feeling so confined in luxury lodges, they want to really reconnect back to nature. The Stella Escape is a really easy walk, and it's a beautiful one night, you know, out in the open. But we have seen a demand on people asking to do more extensive hiking, really get out there. So we've now launched the Trails Camp, a similar concept to the Stella Escapes. We still have the sleep out under the Milky Way, except the walk is much more extensive, 8 to 12 kilometers a day. Days and afternoons, all part of this walking trail, private rail, is just a much more extended walk. Because it's always done exclusively, we can still tailor the hikes. You'd want to have some level of fitness, especially as a lane over game trails. But this one is very excited to be launching this now. People really do want to get out more in nature, not do a hardcore survival training trail, but connect with nature. And who knows? Since we've launched these trails and are developing them under canvas, we've been approached by more partners in Namibia to open under canvas camps in their areas. So maybe in a year's time when I do another Atta webinar, I have more ad in my short 15 minutes. Then I quickly want to address the scheduled safaris. We essentially a tailor-made operator, but we do have what we call our ultimate Namibia 10-day scheduled trip. Pretty much departs nearly every Tuesday this year. We've got our 2019 rates out as well. We've got all the highlights of Namibia. The groups are kept small, guaranteed departure on one person, maximum seven. Amazing value for anybody who's interested in joining the safari. We also have lots of other options that we can do and put together for you. One of the things I think it's people underestimate is that either or they drive, which can be exhausting for 2 weeks, or fly, which is expensive. So one thing we really encourage people to do is look at a combination tour. Maybe fly to the south and Swaziland fly over shipwrecks up to Damaraland, and there the guide meets them and does a private tour through the river systems looking for elephants, private drives inside the Etosha Park. So you've got the best of both worlds, and you really get an experience, the vantage points and the vastness of Namibia, both by air and road. So if anything, see if you can offer guest combination tours. Now, I've mentioned the agent login site. We've created this for the trade only. All the information you possibly need on Namibia and some more, including insider tips, you know, what to do in Windhoek over a weekend. Do you want to go there over a weekend? It's also got our ultimate Namibia live availability chart. You still have to email us to make the extra bookings, but considering all the time zones, this is very helpful for you. And this is me, my speed dating with all of you. I hope you liked what we did here. Valentine's Day is next week as well. So it's very short and sweet. Please, you can reach out to me afterwards if you need more information, clarifications. If the sound didn't work so well, I'm happy to talk to you on the phone as well. But yeah, I hope you guys got some value out of these 15 minutes with you. And thank you for joining.
Great. Thank you very much, Birgit. We've already had one question come through from Valerie. Do you have a recommended season for the hiking trails?
Yes, I mean, it is. That's why we do operate them only from April to November. It is the best time to do it. And I'm glad you guys mentioned the season because I nearly forgot to mention something. For some, Namibia has been frustratingly fully booked, or that's the assumption. And yes, August has been very fully booked because we have lots of family coming to Namibia in August. It's school holidays. There's only so many family units. But Namibia is actually a year-round great destination. January is the hottest time. And if I would say probably not to come for anything really, it's January. Hiking, definitely not. So if you have people that are honeymooners or couples or tired people, encourage them to look at other months of the year because year-round generally Namibia is a really beautiful time to see. But our under-canvas camps are open April to November because it does get hot for the rest of the time. And we also need to give our camp crew a break and do our annual maintenance.
Okay, just following on.
Asking a question as well.
Just following on from your from the hiking question. Do you have a minimum age for the hiking, or is it open to all ages of children?
It's done exclusively each time. It's open to all children. Naturally, it would make no sense to go with a two-month-old baby and trying to hike because the terrain is rough. But that means we can cater it. So are we just going to do literally stroll down the riverbed because the terrain is smoother there? Do we do an afternoon? The Stella Escapes is probably better for younger kids because the trail camp does have a bit longer walking.
Okay, that's fantastic. A few more questions are coming in, so I'll address them in order. From Alexis Berry, can you remind me how many guide rooms are there at Haub Camp?
Depends. So currently we've got two dome tents on a sharing basis, but the guide tents are being used by our own guides because they have to host the guests. So if it's an outside guide, he will probably be accommodated in the guest room, the guest tent. And just to clarify, we have maximum of 8 tents at our under canvas camps.
Okay, question from Frank. Do we need to request for login details for the agent login?
Yes, on our website in the top right corner you see something sign up. Sign up has got all this list of your name and registration stuff. Register and I approve you. And then you get an email with your required things and you just sign in.
Wonderful. So question now from Tom. But where are the hikes done? Are they in Sossus or Damaraland or in both?
So at the moment, the short hikes, the Stella Escapes, are done both in Sossus and Damaraland. But the trails camp is done in Damaraland at this stage because this is one that we've just developed. We've identified spots for picnics. There's not a lot of shades in Damaraland, so we really had to be focused. With time, we'll do it in Sossus Flay as well. We'll just have to develop the trail camp.
Okay, and that's also answered Josie's question as to where the trails camp is located. So thank you for that one. Just seeing a couple of people still typing messages. But I've certainly found this fascinating and very educational. One more question that's come in from Sadie. Are there any restrictions on age, as in upper age limits for clients?
No, not at all either. I mean, again, to be aware, this is far away from any medical facilities and it's rough terrain. Because we catered exclusively each time, we can definitely cater to guests of all ages. Again, because you don't have to worry about other guests, you know. But you always want to be aware if you're a very old guest, then it's a little bit more challenging.
Yes, need to be aware of the climate and the conditions and everything else that goes with
it. Yeah. And it's generally in Namibia, I don't think it's limited to under canvas. You know, most places are remote and far to reach. So, you know, but we've hosted successfully guests ages 80, 90. It's all relative, isn't it, to how fit they are?
100%. Still got a couple coming in, so we're going to keep it while the questions are coming through. Okay, another question from Valerie saying she did the 3-day trek after We Are Africa, the fish, but it was very hot, more than 35 degrees. Is it the same up in Damaraland and Sossus?
Yeah, it is. But the problem with the trek of the Fish River is it's a full day, and the Fish River Canyon tends to be quite, in the canyon, there's like no wind and things. They actually had to cancel the canyon hike because of low water. Which is again what's so nice about Damaraland Sossus. It's tailored. You know, Fish River, yeah. You have to walk from one to another. So you can't actually say, today I'm going to chill today because I don't want to go there, because you have to end the trail. Whereas ours is a circuit. And there's always our cars on standby. So whenever something is a situation, guests are tired and things like that, our guides are within radio access or the vehicle. So we can always pick them up and drive them. This advantage is doing something exclusively. It's completely up to the guests.
Wonderful. And I'll now just address the last two questions. Can you confirm that there's the Himba visit at Haub?
It is. This is the one that I also visited. It's about 2 hours from our camp to the Himba. It's a rough road. No, longer. It's actually, I'm lying. It's about 3-4 hours because it's quite rough terrain. About 3 hours, really, 4 hours. And then a couple of hours at the Himba. But we do a day excursion. So we do scenic drive. We have a picnic lunch there. So if guests stay 3 nights, we actually do visit the Himba, the one, two. And again, this is the nice thing about exclusivity. We can talk to our guide, can talk to guests on site, saying, well, you want to go this? We'll do a day trip and a day adventure of it. Are you up for it? And guests always love it, as long as they know it's a full day trip.
Okay, great. And just the final question, with regards to the set safari, did you say it was each week and is 10 days long? And was the price in dollars, not rand?
Yeah, so it pretty much departs nearly every Tuesday, starting as from now next. It's 10 long. It excludes the nights in winter before and after, so you can optionally add it, which is an idea. We price it in US dollar for the presentation, just to give you a guide like costing, but we actually cost it in rand.
Okay, that's wonderful. Do you have time for just one final question?
Absolutely.
Are the tours only on self-drive, or can guests fly in and meet up with the guide from their under-canvas trip? And which airstrip should they fly into?
It's a very good question, and I think something I've pretty sure I've mentioned before is It's only on guided experiences because the guide hosts them personally at the under canvas, so it's an extension of already a guided tours. We do it for flying safaris as well, not for self-drives because A, the camps are not accessible by self-drives and there's nowhere they can park their vehicles safely for our guide to meet them. And then it becomes quite expensive because we relocate a guide from Windhoek to host them. And we've done exceptions for self-drives in some places for larger groups, but for two guests, it's not worth it. So yeah, generally it's part of a guided experience with Ultimate or a luxury flying safari with Ultimate.
Okay, wonderful. Thank you very much, Birgit. It's been a fascinating presentation and has certainly piqued my interest again, once again, in Namibia. Definitely need to get back there again. I'm not sure when, but definitely need to get back there. But thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much for your time, Birgit, and thank you very much for everyone's time to listen into the webinar. As I mentioned, the recording will be available. It will be sent out either later on today or tomorrow morning to everyone who's registered, and it will also be posted up onto the Atta website. Thank you all very much for your time, and I look forward to being with you all at the next Atta webinar. Thank you.
Yes, and thank you everybody for listening in. Thank you very much. That's why it's raining. Good news.